safety of Greek housing at the University of Idaho is under scrutiny tonight because two students have ended up hospitalized. Both vandals fell from fraternity houses on campus. Moscow police say alcohol was a factor in at least one of those falls. KXLY4's Tanya Dahl spent the day on campus with and has more on what's being done to protect students.
With over two dozen fraternities and sororities at the University of Idaho, Greek life is a big part of being a vandal. But now university officials and police are looking into underage drinking and the safety of many of these houses.
It's too bad, really, because you have one rotten egg spoiling the rest.
Only 4 weeks into the semester and already vandal Greeks are being watched closely.
It's been a challenging start. We have had two very rare accidents occur in close proximity to one another, both physically on campus and in time.
Two sophomores within 2 weeks of each other fell from frat houses on campus. Investigators say on August 29th, 20-year-old Shane Mayer toppled off the Delta Tau Delta building. Then last Thursday, 19-year-old Amanda Andoverdi fell out of a window at Sigma Alpha Epsilon. She'd been attending a party at the frat house.
When I heard about it the second time, I thought, okay, well, something's obviously happening in the fraternities and sorority life, so something fishy must be going on.
We've only been here for 2.5 weeks, and like, you don't see people out of Greek that are falling out of windows.
Moscow police confirmed that alcohol was a factor in last week's fall. Both students who are underage are fighting an uphill battle. A banner flying at the sorority wishes Shane a speedy recovery.
Both two students suffered skull fractures and numerous other broken bones.
U of I says both buildings were recently renovated, but it's looking into why these accidents happened, asking the privately run Greek houses to provide a safety audit. They hope it'll stop future falls.
It's just crazy how that can happen, you know? Like, why are people falling out of windows like this? Like, people need to stop getting so intoxicated.
Both students are still in intensive care at Harborview Medical Center in Seattle. Mayer is listed in serious condition, and Andoverdi is listed in critical condition. Reporting from Moscow, Tanya Dahl, KXLY4, HD News.